Hello guys, how are you all? Are you all happy and safe? I know you will be. And today I have a surprise for you. Curious to know? Yes, my screen space will be shared by most of your friends. Happy? Yes, today for lesson Matchbox, your friends will be coming with their own explanations. And do listen to them. Enjoy and be careful to take down the notes and all the informations shared by them. Fine, over to the screen for Matchbox.
So, hi guys, we're actually here to take you over to the next page of what we were going through. So, what was the chapter's name? The chapter's name was The Matchbox, written by the famous Bengali writer Asha Poorna Devi. So, in this story, the author compares women to matchboxes. And for justifying this statement, she leads us to a three-story house. That is a palatial house where there are two main protagonists. And who are they? Yes, they are Namita and Ajay. So actually, it was a Sunday morning and Namita was actually taking Ajit's clothes to the washroom and waiting down there. So for verifying that nothing is left on the pockets, she just searches the pocket and finds out a letter. So she looks on to the address and for her astonishment, she finds out that the letter was actually to Namita and not to Ajit. So she felt irritated because Ajit hadn't even mentioned about the letter to Namita at least once. And he had already read that letter too. So you know how it feels when your letter is being read by someone else, right? So Namita too felt in the same way. But the author says us that this was not a casual oversight at their home. It's deliberate. So we can understand that this usually happened with them. So you want to know what is going to happen next? So we can see what is going to happen next.
Hi friends, this is Vishmaya and myself Akshaya.
Hope all are fine and safe at home. So let's begin. Ajit's nature is exactly like that. Somehow, he's gained possession of a key to the letterbox, fishing it through the gaps among the 52 hands of this joint family. And whenever there's a letter with Namita's name on the envelope, he opens and reads it first, and only then does he give it to her. It's possible that oftentimes he doesn't give it to her at all. At least, that's a suspicion that has taken deep root into Namita's mind.
Here, Ajit's character is being explained. Ajit belongs to a joint family and he somehow managed to get the right of the key to the letterbox which contain the letters which have arrived to the family members. And here Namita feels that whenever Ajit finds a letter to Namita, he often open and read it. And sometimes may give it to Namita and the other times may not. And this is what the suspicion means doubt. And this is what the suspicion that has taken deep root in Namita's mind.
Let's take a look at the next paragraph.
Even though to this day Ajit cannot truthfully make the claim that he has been able to discover any letter in the slightest degree suspicious, still this ugly habit of his won't go.
Till this day, Ajit cannot find any suspicious matter to complain against Namita. But still, he continues his bad character of opening the envelope which has came to Namita. Here, once again, the character of Ajit is expressed.
Hope you all understood the portion.
So, our friends will explain the rest of the chapter. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's move on to the next part.
Still this ugly habit of his won't go. Not with Namita's anger, not with her taking offense, not with bitter reproaches, her trying to shame him, sarcasm, not with anything. If she mentions it, first he tries to laugh it away, and if laughter doesn't get him out of deep water, he scolds her. She sits perfectly still for a minute and reads the letter through. It's nothing much, a letter from Nomita's mother.
Now, we get a glimpse of Ajit's character, which is portrayed as ugly. There is no change in his character even with Nomita's efforts. She reacted to him in different ways. What was her reactions? She was angry. She took offense of him. What is offense?
So friends, offense means feeling of hurt or annoyance.
Okay, Suvenia, can you help me to find out the meanings of the words reproaches and sarcasm?
Yes, of course. Reproaches means express disapproval of or disappointment with. And sarcasm means use of irony to mock or to convey contempt.
Okay. So, Nomita was angry, took offense of him, mocked him, and even tried to approach him bitterly. But all of these went in vain. If she tries to mention this character, Ajit would simply ignore it by a mere laugh. If laughter is not getting him out of his trouble, he would scold her. Have you noticed the usage out of deep water? What does that mean? The usage out of deep water means out of trouble. Then Nomita starts to read the letter after a pause. Whose letter was that? It was her mother's letter.
Okay, so let's move on with the chapter.
It's her standard speech. The good woman has once again placed on the record the news of her various hardships and complaints getting worse. Misfortune upon misfortune. The ceiling of her room is cracked and the rainwater falls through in ceaseless streams. If this is not immediately remedied, she will have to die crushed under the weight of a collapsed roof. Of course, she does not dread that eventuality. Her daughter is a queen, her son-in-law high-minded, large-hearted, therefore, etc., etc.
Okay, so as we have said, Nomita now reads the letter from her mother. But throughout the letter, she finds that her mother goes on complaining about things, such as the ceiling of her room is cracked and the rainwater falls through it in ceaseless streams. So, what do you mean by ceaseless?
The word ceaseless means constant and unending.
Yes, so the rainwater was flowing endless. And I hope you could imagine this pathetic situation. She also says that if this is not remedied, she may die crushed under the weight of the collapsed roof, but she does not dread that eventuality. So friends, now let's familiarize with the words dread and eventuality.
The word dread means fear and the word eventuality means a possible event or outcome.
So that means she does not mind her death because she believes that her daughter will help her to escape out of this pathetic condition. So from this letter, we understand that poverty is the cause of mother's worry and pride and greed are her inherent characters. So friends, hope you are clear with our session. And now let's lend our ears to Shweta and Chaitanya.
Hi Chaitanya.
Hi Shweta, how are you?
Yes, I am fine.
Have you seen Srinandana's and Suvenia's class?
Yes, I have seen their class. Now, we both are ready to take you to the next part of the story. Are you ready?
Yes. An indigent widow, without husband or son, she was successful in consigning her daughter to a wealthy family's house on the strength of looks alone. But the good lady has never stopped taking credit at the slightest opportunity for her skill in the matter. And she's been finding such opportunities all along.
The meaning of indigent is poor, right?
Right.
Here we can see a clear-cut picture of Namita's mother. Even though she was poor and a widow, she was successful in her daughter's marriage. That too, only because of her looks, Namita was married to a wealthy family. But this woman knows every trick to turn the silly situations into her favor.
Why did you say that, Shweta?
The answer for your question is in the next paragraph. Whenever Ajit sees a new letter from Namita's mother, he smiles derisively and says, "Why bother to read that? I'll go and fill out a money order form."
Yes, in the paragraph, we can see Ajit's reaction on seeing mother's letter. He understands that Namita's mother is in need of money and goes fill the money order form without even reading the letter. Namita's mother has taken granted over the money of her son-in-law. Yes, Shweta?
Yes, I too agree with that. Now, we can move to the third paragraph.
Namita's head hangs low with the shame and the insult of it. So, some time ago, out of anger and grief, Namita's forbade her mother from writing to her on postcard. She thought that from then on she would try to send her little money, whatever she could pull together, in secret. So this was what came of letters in envelopes too.
Here we can see Namita facing a shameful and a painful situation whenever she receives a letter from her mother, as we have seen Ajit's reaction in the last paragraph. Namita, out of this anger and grief, has asked her mother to not to write her letters. Instead, she will try to send away some little money that she could pull away together from Ajit's house in secret. Is it, Chaitanya?
Yes.
Hope you might have enjoyed our session. Now, Anaga will conclude it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, what a situation, right? So you guys would be really excited to know what is going to happen next. So here comes the next group to continue with the chapter. Stay tuned.
Now, Namita is so disappointed by the action of her mother. Pleading for help again and again, at times she would send her mother some money in secret whenever she could manage. But her mother has made this as a usual habit. When all these thoughts popped up on Namita's mind, suddenly she got so angry with her mother. Namita's rage in her eyes would have burnt everything in front of her. But she didn't. Women do have emotions, right? They do get exhausted. A woman always expects her family to understand her. And that situation will be so worse if their family too does not support them. And here, Namita keeps on thinking, why? Why does her mother keep on begging like this? Why won't she let Namita keep her self-respect and dignity? The only thought of her mother is that her daughter is a queen and son-in-law a large-minded, kind-hearted, etc. and keeps on asking money as her son-in-law is from a wealthy family. And her mother does not give a least value to Namita's self-respect. Basically, every human being deserves self-respect. Am I right? Yes. But at last, even though with so much of grief inside, Namita decides to write a letter to her mother and make her point very clear that she cannot help anymore and not to expect anything from her.
At that moment, Ajit comes there after his leisurely bath. During his relaxing Sunday bath, he never thought about the horrible atmosphere outside. The reason is that Ajit never permits Namita even to read the letter sent to her. But she found it from his pocket. This made Namita depressed and felt anger about him. Even though he knew that Namita doesn't like this character of him, then also he does the same. Why did Namita burst like that? What may be the reason? Can you share your thoughts, Yugandhara?
As far as we have understood Namita, Nomita is not an exploding kind of character. Most of the time, she has controlled her emotions. But now, what made Nomita so angry is that Ajit opened the letter addressed to Nomita and she has said 1,000 times not to. The male dominance and doing anything to a wife to have an immense control on her is not a good trait. Don't you think? Yes. And this is what that made Nomita so angry.
Yes, you are right. He didn't know the magnitude of his error. He feels so cool. He neglected Nomita. He didn't give any importance to her words. He thought to tear it up and throw it away and decided not to give letter to Nomita. But he never expected that Nomita would get the letter and she would read it. He was not a true husband because from the beginning of their married life itself, she told Ajit to open or discuss all the matters happened in their life. But he doesn't stick to her words. He has done a big mistake, but he was not feeling ashamed of that.
Ajit pretended for Nomita's question, as if he don't know about any letter. After thinking a while, he said, "Oh, yes, yes, that letter. I just hadn't got around to giving it to you." Do you think whether Ajit was right to his wife, Nomita?
He's not right. As a husband and wife, they should share everything each other. But here it is not like that. He's failed to become a true husband.
Yes, you are right, my friend. Ajit is a quite arrogant man and has no respect towards others' feeling. Through this, we can understand that he is a suspicious husband. He do not care the privacy of any woman.
We can see Nomita's uncontrolled anger towards her husband Ajit. She hisses towards him just like a snake and questions him for opening the letter which has arrived for her. The incident happened for Nomita is similar to the life of all women. We can analyze ourselves as Nomita. In this world around us, many women are facing such a problem as Nomita. Since it's her personal matter and Ajit has interfered in it and he hid it from her. This was the mistake made by Ajit and his action of Ajit had turned Nomita into angry. Here we can see male domination. Ajit has denied her freedom and interfered in her personal matter.
That it is not good habit to read the personal letter of anybody. Even though let it be his wife letter, Ajit does not have the right to open and read it without the permission of Nomita. It is not for the first time that Ajit is reading her letter. Whenever he receives a letter with Nomita's name on the envelope, he used to open it and read it and then only used to give it to Nomita. It is possible that oftentimes he does not give it to Nomita.
Without any doubt, we can understand the value of women's words in her family. We must try to change our attitude towards women. Both men and women have right to do what they like, but they should not go across their limit. There are so many women who face the same problem of Nomita.
Aishwarya, if you are in the place of Nomita, what you will do?
I am in the place of Nomita. The same situation will happen. Any woman can't tolerate this. And both men and women should treat as equal. Freedom of woman should not be declined.
Moving towards the next paragraph, Ajit was not concerned about Nomita's anger. He was feared to fight with her. So he keeps a fake smile and continue. What if it was a letter that is sent by your lover to you? So, in this line, the author represents an unhealthy relationship that is prevailing in some family. We can see the same situation that is prevailing in Ajit and Nomita's life. So, Ratika, what is your opinion? Is this the right way?
Definitely no, Ashwati. Here there is a male dominance over a woman. And both women and men have their own personal matter. And no male has the right to interfere in the personal matter of women.
Absolutely, Ratika. What you said is right. Moving towards the next line. Nomita, she burst out with anger and she called her husband a vulgar man. After all possible scenario, Ajit was not able to put a fake smile. So, in this paragraph, the author is trying to convey the fact that as men, woman also has equal importance in both family and society.
And now, let's listen
to the heated argument of Nomita and Ajit.
When did this letter arrive?
Letter? What letter? Oh, yes, yes. Indeed, there was a letter from your mother. I just hadn't got around to giving it to you.
Why hadn't you got around to it? Why? Answer me, why hadn't you got around to it?
What a nonsense.
Liar.
Why are you saying whatever comes to your mouth? Don't people forget?
No, they don't. Why did you open it?
What if I opened it? My own wife's letter.
Be quiet. I tell you, for what reason you opened my letter? Haven't you? I told 1,000 times not to it.
If you are forbidding it, then it's a definite something. Shouldn't I make sure that no one is passing you love letters in secret?
What a common vulgar man you are.
And now, let's look some new words from this page.
Now he too picks up the poison knife. From this it is clear that until that time he was trying to avoid the problem with a smile, but now he decided to give her a befitting reply. And he replied, "Is that so? Those who whine day and night and hold out their palms to their son-in-law, they are the high-class people. A dung picker's daughter becomes a queen." Here, Ajit had humiliated both his wife and his mother-in-law by saying that she is a dung picker's daughter and her mother is always pleading in front of him for money. Here, whine means a long and high-pitched complaining cry or sound. Shut up, Nomita hears. Their room is on the third floor, that's a blessing. Otherwise, with that scream, everyone would have come to look. Ajit's reply had made Nomita angry and she asked Ajit to shut up. And their room is on the third floor, that's a blessing. Otherwise, everyone would have heard them and they may come and look. Shut up, Ajit roars out. What shut up? I will do what I want, what I please. What will you do? Can you do anything? Her reply made Ajit angry and he is asking to her in a manner that who is she to ask him to shut up. And he also says that he will do whatever he want, and he is saying to her in a challenging manner what she can do to it. I can't do anything, almost panting. Nomita pronounces each word clearly. You want to see if I can do anything. Here, Nomita is telling that you want to see if I can do anything. It's like a reply to her. It's like a reply to him that he had already said that can you do anything? And and as a reply to that, she's telling that you want to see what if I can do anything. Do you want to see? That's all.
And immediately she does something that is astonishing. She grabs Ajit's matchbox that is lying near his cigarettes on the table and she lights a matchstick and touches it to her saree. So when her rage exceeds her limit, she does something astonishing. She takes the matchbox and lights a matchstick and touches it to her saree. Instantly it flares up, the very fine ancol of a wealthy wife's saree. We all know wealthy saree would be made up of silk or something that is light. So whenever she touches the lit matchstick to her sari, it burns up quickly. The very next instant, Ajit, having gone mad, he says and jumps into her side and grabs the burning patch and slaps it between his hands and puts out the fire. So seeing this, Ajit's a bit shocked. So he jumps and puts out the fire by slapping it between his hands. And to tell the truth, now he is a little afraid. He looks fearfully at Nomita's face, sees a fire burning there, bright, blazing red. The fire was burning, but he puts out the fire. But when he sees Nomita's face, it was very fearful than the fire that he has put out. It was blazing red.
So, let's go through the next paragraph. He doesn't have the courage to put out that fire by slapping it between his hands. So he tries to pour water on it. With great difficulty, he attempts to speak normally. You lose all common sense when you get angry, don't you? A woman and such anger. Ajit was trying to put off that fire. Instead of slapping it between his hands, he poured water onto it because he was afraid to do so. And he blames Namita in doing that particular act. Who knows what Namita would have said next. But right then, her niece Rini steps into the room. Another character, Rini, who is the niece of Namita, enters the room. And she came in for telling something. Let's see what she says. Immediately she says, piercingly, she addresses Namita and she says, "How much longer does the washerman have to wait? If you don't want to give him any of your clothes, at least tell him that." The washerman was waiting outside because the story began when Namita was carrying the laundry to be given to the washerman. At that time, she finds an envelope from Ajit's pocket and she forgot about the washerman reading it. And that washerman was waiting outside, waiting for the laundry. And Rini came in by saying that the washerman was waiting outside, and if they doesn't have anything to be given, that is any dress.
For a second or two, Namita is still, perhaps recalling the washerman's face, waiting for her downstairs. Then she pick up the dirty clothes and start sorting them. She says in a calm tone, "Go tell him I am coming. I am bringing the clothes." The fight with the Ajit made her to forget the washerman who was waiting for her in the downstairs. As soon as she recalled him, she took up the dirty clothes which was thrown away by her and began to sort them. Namita speaks her mind, so no one attack her outright to her face. They only pinch her with the sharp words. She realizes that everyone is hurting her with the sharp words. Her second sister-in-law is almost exhausted with the work this morning. And seeing her, she put a twisted smile on her sweat-streaked face and says, "Well, that's something. At least you finally decided to come down from upstairs. Baba, there is no good or bad time for you. You find the smallest excuse to go into your room and get cozy with your husband. Does the loud talk never gets old?" Her second sister-in-law was busy and exhausted from the morning work. From this paragraph, we could understand that Namita is always remaining apart from the family in her room. On the perception of the family, Namita finds the smallest time to go into her room and get cozy with her husband. Now, I welcome the commerce students to take the next paragraph.
Hi, I hope that all are fine. And ma'am, thanks for giving us a wonderful opportunity. Now let's move on to the story.
Downstairs, she just look around her to understand the understand the atmosphere in the downstairs. When she looked around her, it was a hurry-burry morning because today is Sunday. Nobody will go to job today. So it was there was a forest of people around her. Because Ajit's family is a very big family. It's a joint family. There are 52 members are there in his family. So it was a very big family. She told to her sister in a tremble in his soft voice. So they cannot understand because she told her that they are not fighting each other. She told in soft voice that her sister want to peek inside their room to know what is happening inside her. She also told that they were not talking in a lovely manner, in a loud talks, etc. They always talk in angry manner. They will not talk in lovely manner. If you want to know, she told to be care in her room.
In this topic, major wife, who is the second oldest brother's wife, and next, no wife. She is the fourth oldest brother's wife. In this topic, major wife is laughs and says that don't cover up with the forbidden fish with your pious spinach. Why she is saying? Because it is an explanation that it is a warning to Namita that the other members in the family know about the noisy fight happening in the room. And it is a meaningless to hide the truth now. So that Major wife is saying to Nomita that why should we need to peek in?
Nomita laughs a laugh that brings an attractive flush to the white face. After laughing that laugh, she says, "Go on. You say the naughtiest thing."
The busy Bora wife runs up. "Have you chopped the vegetables yet, or are you just telling stories?" It means the new wife and the other ladies was talking. Then came the Bora wife. She asked if the vegetables are chopped or you are sitting and telling stories. And suddenly she stops and starts. "What's that? What's this unlucky thing, new wife? How did you burn your anger that way?" It means suddenly she noticed new wife. Anger is burns and asks how that happens.
"Warning me about, I didn't listen and see what happening. I used my alcohol to lift a hot pot of water off the stove and that did it."
Nomita pulls the basket of potatoes towards herself and starts to peel the potatoes. And in her mind she keeps thinking about how she might be able secretly to send her mother a few rupees. She can't really write to her, "I can't do any more, don't hope anything from me." Then Nomita started to peel the potatoes and in her mind she thinking about to send some money to her mother. And she can't write a letter to her, she can't do anything for her.
Over there, the entire village knows Nomita is a queen. Nomita's husband is high-minded, large-hearted. This is precisely why I compare women to matchboxes. Even when they have materials within themselves to set off many raging fires, they never flare up and burn away the mask of men's high-mindedness, their large-heartedness. They don't burn away their own colorful shells. So according to the author, women are compared to matchboxes because unlike matchboxes, all the potential of women is hidden inside them. Although matchboxes are tiny and appear small, they have huge potential to burn out things.
"Burn them, the man knows, these two. That's why they leave them scattered so carelessly. In the kitchen, in the pantry, in the bedroom. Here, there, anywhere. Quite without fear, they put them in their pockets." The poet comments that women are like matchbox and can flare up their own ones. But women do not do so because they are gentle and broad-minded. The poet compares that women are like matchbox because they have the capacity to burn up their masks of all men. But they are not doing so because the men know that they will not burn their own ones or their own productive cells. That's the reason that men are keeping it carelessly or without any respect. As they keep the matchbox in their pockets, women are treated as matchbox.
Every matchbox exhibits about women of different lifestyle, characters and viewpoints. In this chapter, Nomita is a daughter of widowed woman who hasn't any brothers to look after her or inquire about her mother. But then too, she is been married to a rich family due to her good looks. In that family, she doesn't have any voice to speak out or emotion to express. But then, she is been forced to bear its everything silently.
Nomita gets angry at her husband opening and reading her letter. And she gets anger and due to it, she sets fire on herself. But no one bothers. Also, the family members pinches her with many harsh words. The humiliation and the frustration faced by her is so much, but then too, she tolerates everything silently. As the famous quote goes on, "If you educate a man, you educate an individual, and if you educate a woman, you educate a generation." So, the story throws the light on the concept that women should be treated with care and should be allowed to enjoy the life, rights and self-respect with dignity.